Good morning. Today I want to talk to you about commitment. If you've committed to 21 days of prayer and fasting, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for committing to something other than yourself. It's not easy to make commitments, and in the world that we live in today, the fact is that committing to anything other than old number one sometimes is frowned on. We see less and less commitment in society today. Just think for a minute about professional athletes. They make tons of money, and yet they rarely commit to play for one team for their entire careers. They leave and go to other teams, sometimes even arch rivals, for more money. Where is the commitment? But they're not the only ones. College athletes make and break commitments all the time. It hasn't been that long ago that I remember a high school linebacker committed to play for Auburn. He got an Auburn tattoo on his arm. Then he changed his commitment and played his college career for the University of Alabama. Can you imagine? That's against everything I've been taught to believe in. But it isn't just athletes. No, workers used to commit to work for one company their entire career and promote the interest of the company they work for. And in turn, companies would take care of their workers through long careers and on into retirement through pension plans. But in the new world that we have today, the global world where we see outsourcing and automation and periodic reductions in force where people just get laid off at the drop of a hat, people change jobs all the time. It's just the new expectation. As Christians, we're called to be different. We're called to commit to following Jesus Christ. Jesus tells us in Matthew chapter 10, verses 38 and 39, "He who does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it." We often talk about accepting Christ as our Savior, but I have to wonder, what have you committed to Jesus Christ as your Savior? In this passage, Jesus is telling us we are to commit to follow Him to the point of death. It wasn't long after He spoke these words to His disciples that He demonstrated what He meant by picking up His cross and going to Calvary. Jesus didn't commit just a little bit to us. Aren't you glad? He left it all out there on Calvary, not just giving up a part of His life for 21 days. When I think about what Jesus did for me, it makes it a little bit easier when I'm so tempted to check out what people that I haven't talked to in 15 or 20 years might be doing this afternoon with their kids on Facebook. It makes it a little bit easier for me not to drink a soda. Those are the commitments that I've made during these 21 days. So I got to wonder, I know that you've accepted Jesus as your Savior if you're a Christian. What have you committed to Him as your Savior? Is today the day that you'll make a commitment to Jesus Christ?